I'm what you would call a collector of fine art. So when I found this picture of my favorite scene in Ace Ventura, I knew I had to get it.
Kind of hot in these rhinos.
Then my best friend drew this hopefully not too accurate picture of me. So it's time to make some fine art picture frames. I started with some rough sawn curly maple and began the milling process. I ripped the board into 2-inch strips and then sent them through the planer to flatten everything out. Because this is fine art, I need to make these frames extra fancy. So we're going to add a padauk inlay? I don't know. I'm not sure how to say that, and you probably don't either, so you're going to have to take my word for it. But we're going to go with padauk. But anyway, I ripped an 1/8-inch strip down the middle of the maple, well, off to the side, threw in some padauk, and flattened everything out. I pulled out a tiny gold bar just to show how rich I am, and rubbed it on the table saw blade for good luck. The blade was about 1/4 inch up, with the fence being about 3/8 inch away, which will give me a nice rabbit to hold all the artwork. And because I put chamfers on everything, I threw in a chamfer bit and added one to the inside edge of the frame. I rechecked the measurements of the artwork, and then it was over to the picture frame sled to cut everything out. The sled is not my design. A guy named David Picciuto over at Make Something is the one that came up with this. But it is hands down my favorite way to make a picture frame, so I'll link you to his video below so you can check it out and build one for yourself. Years ago, I bought this metal picture frame jig for gluing things up. I used it one time and I thought it was a piece of trash and never used it again. But I dusted everything off for this project to try it one more time to make sure it wasn't just user error. And no, it is still a piece of trash, so that's where it belongs. So after sanding away all the glue-up mistakes, it was over to the table saw to add in some splines. I swapped out my regular table saw blade for one with a flat tooth grind. If you make your spline cuts with a regular blade, it can leave little gaps that need to be filled in. I set up my spline jig on the table saw and eyeballed the dead center. Man, perfect on the first try. There's no way I can screw this up. Or maybe there is.
I forgot to lock the fence.
This is a problem. I wandered back over to the miter station so I could spend some time cutting all my hard work up into little tiny pieces. Then pulled the picture frame jig back out again, reset everything up, and cut everything back out once more. Then instead of digging through the garbage outside for that stupid metal jig, I went with the old standby and just used some green tape. Works every time. I resawed up some padauk, which leaves your bench looking like a crime scene, and then gave it a light sanding so it's a tight fit into the spline cuts. Now to just quickly cut it out at the bandsaw, and of course I forgot to tension the blade. You ever have one of those days in the shop where you think you should probably just turn the lights off and go upstairs, but no, how many more things could I possibly screw up? Once I put my bandsaw blade back on and actually had the ability to cut the splines out, I glued everything in, let it dry, and sanded everything flush. Finally, it's time for some finish. For this project, I'm going to use walrus furniture oil. I use their cutting board oil on all my cutting boards, so I thought I'd give this a shot. And boy, was that a good decision. Look at the way that oil makes that curly maple come to life. Absolutely stunning. But it's also curly maple. It's always stunning. I checked the measurements of my rabbit and then cut out a sheet of acrylic over on the table saw. Glass would work perfectly fine, but I don't have a glass cutter, so work with what you got. I cut up one of the few thousand Amazon boxes I have laying around my house to use as a backer. If you're going to give this as a gift to somebody, you may want to go with something fancier, but this is just going in my office. So I threw in a few nails to hold that in place. Tapped on one of those alligator clip picture hanger thingies, and finally stuck in some of those plastic nubs to keep it away from the wall. So there we have it, 2 absolutely gorgeous framed pieces of art. I even screwed up the walnut one as well and cut the first spline off center, but now it's a feature. So I added a second spline, and now it looks like I did that on purpose. I think I like the double spline even better than the single.